Hello dear students, welcome back to physics online classes. Let us start the new chapter from the track 2, that is chapter number 11, dual nature of radiation and matter. What do you mean by dual? Dual is nothing but two. Okay, radiation has two natures and also matter has two natures. So the radiation has wave nature and particle nature, and also the matter has wave nature and particle nature. See here, it is a matter. Now this chalk is a matter. Okay, so it is already a particle. Whenever this particle is in motion, the wave associated with this particle. Okay, means this matter having particle nature and also wave nature. But the wave nature of the moving particle was discovered by the physicist Louis de Broglie in 1924. Okay, but in this chapter we are going to discuss about the particle nature of radiation and the wave nature of matter. Radiation or light. Radiation or light has dual nature. Has dual nature. So what are those natures? Wave nature and particle nature. Wave nature of the light can be explained by the phenomenon like, what are those? Interference, diffraction and polarization. Once again, listen here. The wave nature of the light can be explained by the phenomenon like interference, diffraction and polarization. Then, and another nature of the light, what is that? Particle nature. Means, sometimes the light behaves as a wave. So, in the phenomenon like interference, diffraction and polarization, the light behaves as a wave. But sometimes the light behaves as a particle. In the phenomenon like electron emission and photoelectric effect. Then the particle nature of the light can be explained by the phenomenon like electron emission and photoelectric effect. In this chapter we are going to discuss about the particle nature of light, and also we are going to discuss about electron emission and photoelectric effect. So now, what do you mean by electron emission? So electron emission is nothing but it is the phenomenon of emission of the free electrons from the surface of the metal. Okay, so what do you mean by electron emission? It is the phenomenon of emission of free electrons from the surface of the metal. Electron emission. So what do you mean by electron emission? It is the phenomenon of emission of another word used for the emission is ejection. Emission or ejection. It is the phenomenon of emission of free electrons from the surface of the metal. So why only we are going to use the metal for the ejection of electrons or emission of electrons? Because the metals having the free electrons, surface of the metals. Okay, so there are three methods of electron emission. What are those methods? Methods of electron emission. methods of electron emission. In three ways we are going to remove the electrons from the metallic surface. What are those ways or what are those methods? First method is called thermionic emission. Thermo means here heat. Thermionic emission. And second method is field emission. Field emission. And third method is photoelectric emission. Then let us discuss one by one. What do you mean by thermionic emission? What do you mean by field emission? And what do you mean by photoelectric emission? So what do you mean by thermionic emission? Again, it is the phenomenon of emission of free electrons from the surface of the metal when a heat energy is supplied to it. Okay. Whenever the heat energy is supplied to the metal now, there is an ejection of electrons will be takes place from the surface of the metal. So this process is called thermionic emission. First one, thermionic emission. Thermo means here heat. First one, thermionic emission. Then what do you mean by thermionic emission? It is the phenomenon of emission of free electrons. What do you mean by free electrons? Free electrons are nothing but these are the loosely bound electrons. Free electrons from the surface of metal. From the surface of metal. When a heat energy is supplied to it. When a heat energy is supplied to it. It means here metal. Whenever we are going to supply the heat energy to the metal, there is an emission of electrons will be takes place from the surface of the metal. This phenomenon is called thermionic emission. It is a metal. So whenever we are going to supply the heat energy here, there is an ejection of electrons will be takes place from the surface of the metal. So this phenomenon is called thermionic emission. Electrons will be ejected from the surface of the metal whenever we are going to supply the heat energy. This phenomenon is called thermionic emission. Then what about second one? Second one is that it is a field emission. Second one, field emission. Again, it is the phenomenon of emission of free electrons from the surface of a metal when a strong electric field is applied to it. When a strong electric field is applied to the metal. So what do you mean by field emission? It is the phenomenon of emission of free electrons. So whenever we are going to give the heat energy or whenever we are going to apply the electric field, the electrons start to vibrate about their mean position, then they are ejected from the surface now. Okay. So whenever we are going to supply the heat energy or whenever we are going to apply the electric field, it is the phenomenon of emission of free electrons from the surface of metal. From the surface of metal. when a strong electric field is applied to it. When a strong electric field is applied to it. So what is the order of the strong electric field applied to the metal here? That is in the order of 10 to the power of 8 volt per meter. So how much electric field is required to eject the electrons from the metallic surface here? That is in the order of 10 to the power of 8 volt per meter. See here, it is metal now. Whenever we are going to apply the strong electric field to the metal, what happens here? There is an ejection of electrons will be takes place from the surface of the metal, because these electrons are loosely bound electrons. Okay, and this phenomenon of emission of electrons from the metallic surface is called the field emission, because by applying strong electric field we are going to eject the electrons from the metallic surface. Next, last one, that is photoelectric emission. In this chapter we are going to study about photoelectric emission. Photo means here light. Light is made up of particles. Those particles are called photons. So light behaves as a wave, and also light behaves as a particle. Third one, photoelectric emission. Then what do you mean by photoelectric emission? It is also the emission of the free electrons from the surface of the metal when a light of suitable frequency falls on it. Okay. So what do you mean by photoelectric emission here? It is the phenomenon of emission of free electrons from the surface of metal. When a light of suitable frequency, falls on it. See, it is a metallic surface. Whenever there is a light of suitable frequency falls on the metallic surface, there is an ejection of electron will be takes place. Whenever the light of suitable frequency falls on the metallic surface, there is a removal of electron, or there is a ejection of electron, or there is a emission of electron will be takes place from the metallic surface. Previously we discussed about what is electron emission and what are the types of electron emission. Now we are going to discuss the minimum energy required to remove an electron from the surface of the metal. Okay. So the minimum energy required by an electron to just escape from the surface of the metal, that minimum energy is called work function of the metal. Now let us discuss what you mean by work function. Work function is denoted by pi naught. In some books it is denoted by W, don't confuse. So work function is denoted by pi naught, or work function is denoted by W. Then what do you mean by work function? It is the minimum energy. An electron It is the minimum energy required by an electron to just escape from the metallic surface. From the metallic surface. From the metallic surface. What do you mean by work function here? It is the minimum energy required by an electron to just escape from the metallic surface. Okay, let us consider. So there are free electrons at the metallic surface. To just escape from this metallic surface, there is a minimum energy required by an electron. That minimum energy is called work function. That minimum energy is called work function of the metal. For example, the light of suitable frequency is incident on the metallic surface. Then there is a minimum energy required by an electron to just escape from the surface of the metal. So this minimum energy is called work function. And what is the expression for work function? Or what is the formula for work function? That is y naught is equal to h into nu naught. What do you mean by nu naught here? It is a frequency of the incident radiation, and it is also called threshold frequency. We will once again discuss about the threshold frequency after the photoelectric effect concept. Okay. So what do you mean by work function? Once again listen here. It is the minimum energy required by an electron to just escape from the metallic surface. Then what is the formula for work function here? That is phi naught is equal to h into nu naught, where h is nothing but Planck's constant. And nu naught is nothing but, okay, it is the frequency of incident radiation, and it is also called threshold frequency. What do you mean by threshold frequency here? Threshold frequency is that it is the minimum frequency of the incident radiation for which there is a ejection of electron will be takes place. Okay, then what do you mean by work function? It is a minimum energy required to remove the electron from the surface of the metal. For example, work function for the cesium metal means the minimum energy required for the cesium metal. For cesium metal is 2.14 electron volt. 2.14 electron volt. In atomic physics and nuclear physics, the energy is measured in electron volt, because work function is nothing but it is a minimum energy required by an electron to just escape from the surface of the metal. Okay. And work function for the platinum. Platinum metal is 5.65 electron volt. Means here, to eject an electron from the platinum metallic surface, we required how much energy? 5.65 electron volt. But to eject an electron from the cesium metallic surface, how much energy is required? That is a 2.14 electron volt. Means for the cesium metal we required low energy, but for the platinum metal we are going to use the high energy. That is why cesium metal is the best metal for the emission of electron from the surface of metal, because the work function is minimum for which metal? Cesium metal. That is how much? That is 2.14 electron volt. But work function for the platinum metal is how much? 5.65 electron volt. Means we required maximum energy to eject an electron from the surface of platinum. Okay. So you have to remember the expression for work function, and also you have to remember these two examples. Okay. Work function for cesium and work function for the platinum metal.